أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. بسم الله والحمد لله والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين محمد بن عبد الله وعلى آله وصحبه ومن والاه. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. أما بعد، يقول المولى جل وعلا: الذين آتيناهم الكتاب يتلونه حق تلاوته أولئك يؤمنون به ومن يكفر به فأولئك هم الخاسرون. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala speaks of the Qur'an, and before we talk about the Qur'an, we want to define and understand what the Qur'an is and the significance of the Qur'an. One way to define the Qur'an is to begin the recitation with Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Alhamdulillahi Rabbil Alameen, Ar-Rahman ar-Rahim, Maliki Yawm al-Din, to continue all the way to قُلْ أَعُوذُ بِرَبِّ النَّاسِ مَلِكِ النَّاسِ إِلَهِ النَّاسِ مِنْ شَرِّ الْوَسْوَاسِ الْخَنَّاسِ الَّذِي يُوَسْوِسُ فِي صُدُورِ النَّاسِ مِنَ الْجِنَّةِ وَالنَّاسِ. This way, this is one way to define the Qur'an, is to recite all of it. Another way is to define the Qur'an as Kalamullah al-Munazzal ala Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم al-Muta'abbad bih al-Mutahaddi. It is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And that's why this Qur'an is the most honorable book, or the all honorable book, and the most honorable knowledge among all knowledge, because it is emanating from the all honorable, the all noble, and that is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So the honor of the Qur'an is the fact that it is the words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Kalamullah al-munazzal ala abdihi, Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The one that was revealed upon Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, so no other prophet, no other messenger. Al-muta'abbadu bih. Muta'abbadu bih means we use the Qur'an to worship Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Even in the recitation of the Qur'an, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, ألا أقول ألف لام ميم حرف ولكن ألف حرف ولام حرف وميم حرف. Meaning that with each letter of the Quran that we recite, we reap 10 حسنات. 10 حسنات والله يضاعف لمن يشاء. المتحدي. المتحدي means the one that challenges. As Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قل لأن اجتمعت الإنس والجن على أن يأتوا بمثل هذا القرآن لا يأتون بمثله ولو كان بعضهم لبعض ظهيرا. That if all mankind and the world of jinn were to gather and unify their forces and consolidate their efforts in order to bring a book like what's in the Qur'an or like the Qur'an, they shall not be able to. And the challenge was downgraded later to 10 chapters. And then later to one chapter, which is the shortest of which in the Qur'an is 10 words. But yet no one has ever been able to come up with anything like the Qur'an or part of it. This is what we mean by al-mutahaddi, means that the challenge is everyone, Muslims and non-Muslims alike. It came first and foremost as a linguistic miracle to challenge the Arabs in the area that they were experts at, because they were known to be, you know, the linguists, the masters of language. Kalamullah al-munazzalu ala abdihi Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم al-muta'abbadu bih al-mutahaddi. الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. Who are the ones that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has given the book? Irrespective whether the Christians or the Jews who received the Torah and the Injil and then later embraced Islam, or the Sahaba. What matters here, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. What does tilawa mean? Tilawa does not mean recitation. It certainly includes the meaning of recitation. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, when he commanded the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, stand up in salah at night, for half of the night, one third of it, more or less, he said, مُرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Recite the Qur'an as you are taught by Jibreel alayhi salam, according to the rules of recitation. But here the word is tilawa, not tartil. Tilawa means they recite it as it ought to be recited. That's element number one in the word tilawa. Number two, that they understand it as it ought to be understood. Why? Because it's a system of guidance. Inna hadha al-Qur'ana yahdi lillati hiya aqwam. This Qur'an guides to the best of the best. Inna hadha al-Qur'ana. So how does one receive hidayah if all they can do is just recite the Qur'an and not understand it? There's no hidayah here. Certainly there's an honor of memorizing the Qur'an, but if one stops at that, then another ayah in the Qur'an applies to them, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala criticizes the people of the book, وَمِنْهُمْ أُمِّيُّونَ لَا يَعْلَمُونَ الْكِتَابَ إِلَّا أَمَالِي. And some of them are, ummis means illiterate, or they have wishful thinking that they have a good understanding of the book. But in reality, they don't. وَإِنْهُمْ إِلَّا يَظُنُّونَ. Indeed, they're in a state of doubt. Do we know it? Do we not know it? Do we have the guidance? Do we not have the guidance? So the second element in the word, and the meaning of the word tilawa, is to understand the Quran. The Sahaba of the Prophet ﷺ, the companions of the Prophet ﷺ, they used to say that kunna yani natadabbaruhu bil-layl wa natafaqqaduhu bil-nahar. Fa'utina al-ilma wal-hifdha ma'ana. The way they approach the Quran is that they truly approach it that this is the word of God. And this is the only word of God that we have, nothing else. So therefore, they would recite it at night. They would do qiyam al-layl with it. نَتَدَارَسُهُ meaning that they would study it. They would study the Qur'an. They would study the meanings of the Qur'an, the messages of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. If they come out upon an example, they strive hard to understand it. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, وَمَا يَعْقِلُهَا إِلَّا الْعَالِمُونَ. And none truly understand these examples except those who have knowledge. So they would not pass by an example or a parable that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives in the Qur'an unless they understand it. وَنَتَفَقَّدْهَا فِي النَّهَارِ. And then we would remember what we studied at night in order to apply it during the day. And that's the third element to the word or to the concept, tilawa. So the first of which is tartil, recitation. The second of which is understanding. And the third of which is the application. This is what we as Muslims now, as an ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, need to really go back to, because that was the criteria of success that the Sahaba, the companions of the Prophet ﷺ had, and that's why they were pioneers in every aspect of the world, in every aspect of life. That's why they've conquered the world, because they understood this Quran and they valued this Quran, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, الَّذِينَ آتَيْنَاهُمُ الْكِتَابَ يَتْلُونَهُ حَقَّ تِلَاوَتِهِ. This is how the Quran ought to be approached. This is how the Quran ought to be learned. This is how the Quran had to be, you know, applied. And that's why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gives his divine testimony that this is the way to approach the Quran. This is the way to deal with the Quran. This is the way to accept the Quran. أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. If you have achieved this level, if you achieve this criteria that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes in the Quran, then you truly believe in it. So al-Iman, qawlun wa'amal. Iman is not just, you know, al-Iman ma waqara fil qalb. It's a statement that we utter, and the roots of which is in the heart, and the fruits of which are the actionable items that we do day in and day out. From salah and siyam and zakah and hajj and piety and so on and so forth. So you can see that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ. This is how one claims correctly and justly that they believe in the Quran. Any other claim for someone to memorize the Quran, for example, and to say, I believe in it, no, you have not believed in it. Because you've memorized something that you don't understand, let alone to apply it, right? So therefore, the right approach is that you memorize, you study, understand, and then you apply. And then these words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will come to apply to you as he gives his divine testimony, أُولَٰئِكَ يُؤْمِنُونَ بِهِ وَمَنْ يَكْفُرْ بِهِ فَأُولَٰئِكَ هُمُ الْخَاسِرُونَ. And whoever disbelieves in this Qur'an, indeed those are al-khasirun, and the definite article alif-lam is used here to indicate that the quality of loss is an integral part of these people. Because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala says, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ يَوْمَ الْقِيَامَةِ أَلَا ذَلِكَ هُوَ الْخُسْرَانُ الْمُبِينَ. We go about our lives, we lose a business opportunity, we lose a job, we lose a car, a house, this isn't that. We've lost something. But none can come and say, this is the true loss. This person is a loser. No. The loser, as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala defines them in the Quran, قُلْ إِنَّ الْخَاسِرِينَ الَّذِينَ خَسِرُوا أَنفُسَهُمْ. The true losers are the ones who have lost themselves. وَالْعِيَادَ بِاللَّهِ وَأَهْلِيهِمْ. And their families. Because the guidance of the children and the family is really part of the guidance of those who are the shepherds of the family. And when there's no guidance for the shepherds, oftentimes the default is that the children and rest of the family is misguided. قل إن الخاسرين الذين خسروا أنفسهم وأهليهم يوم القيامة. What is more of a loss that one would lose not only paradise, but they would lose themselves and their families, the destruction of the hellfire for eternity. There is no loss beyond that. There is absolutely no loss. Every opportunity you miss in this life can be made up for. If not in this dunya, in the hereafter. Every agony, every illness, every loss that you've sustained in this dunya, if it's meant for you, inshallah, to enter paradise, you will not even, you know, turn your head towards what you've lost. Like, this is nothing. This is the true winning. فَمَنْ زُحْزِحَ عَنِ النَّارِ وَأُدْخَلَ الْجَنَّةَ فَقَدْ فَازْ. That those who are removed by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala from the punishment of the hellfire and enter paradise again by the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, those are the true winners. إِنَّ هَذَا الْقُرْآنَ يَهْدِي لِلَّتِي هِيَ أَقْوَمْ. This Qur'an guides to the best of the best in every aspect of life. وَكَذَلِكَ أَوْحَيْنَا إِلَيْكَ رُوحًا مِّنْ أَمْرِنَا مَا كُنْتَ تَدْرِي مَا الْكِتَابُ وَلَا الْإِيمَانِ وَلَكِنْ جَعَلْنَاهُ نُورًا نَهْدِي بِهِ مَنْ نَشَاءُ مِنْ عِبَادِنَا. This Qur'an is like the spirit. The spirit of the human being never perishes. The body perishes. When the soul part ways with the body perishes. But the soul rises up. So this Qur'an is, you know, like the soul to the body, is that it never perishes. Similarly, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in other ayat compares this Qur'an to many other things. As he says, وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلْمُؤْمِنِينَ وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. And in this Qur'an, there is truly a shifa. Subhanallah, sometimes I would have a headache. And I begin to read the Qur'an or pray, and all of a sudden the headache subsides. Somebody would have an ailment, like Umar al-Khattab radiallahu anhu arda. You know, he would recite Surah al-Fatiha upon an ill person. And all of a sudden this person is recovering. Why? Because they truly believe that this Qur'an is, you know, a healing power. It has healing powers. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala describes it, وَنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ. In it there is a healing power. وَرَحْمَةً and mercy. To who? To those who believe in it. وَلَا يَزِيدُ الظَّالِمِينَ إِلَّا خَسَارًا. This very same Qur'an that has mercy and shifa, cure, for the believers, it also has an increase in loss for the disbelievers. Because in every ayah and in every letter they disbelieve in, they only sink themselves further and further into the wrath and the punishment of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to guide us to the best of the best of this Qur'an. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to teach us the words of wisdom from the Qur'an, to allow us the right understanding and application of the messages and the words of wisdom in this Qur'an. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر استغفروه سبحانك اللهم بحمدك نشهد أن لا إله إلا أنت نستغفرك ونتوب إليك سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون وسلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.